She went away, and you hung around and bothered me every night. And when I wouldn't go out with you, you said things that weren't very nice. My boyfriend's back and you're gonna be in trouble. Hey la, hey la, my boyfriend's back.
We begin with Zach off to satisfy his sweet tooth with a side of Stacy.
What are we doing?
Just relax and follow me.
However, Stacy would rather fill his mind full of cheese, meat, and butter instead.
Stacy.
Yes, Zach?
I want you to know that I love...
Yes?
How kosher?
I have been called a cheap date before, but this is ridiculous.
Yet Zach can't bring himself to pour out his true feelings about her, yet they were last seen holding hands an episode ago.
I love the way you butter bread.
Then we cut to them at the refreshment stand.
Hey, Stacy, what's this big important announcement your father wants to make?
What is this? Gidget goes Hawaiian?
I promise not to tell.
I just find it odd that they are holding their employee meeting and airing out their dirty laundry with just 7 employees whom only matter enough to have speaking roles.
Maybe he's giving us all raises.
Talk about professionalism. What are Zach Morris and Slater doing without their shirts off? Was this the producers doing so that all the little girls can get that funny feeling downstairs?
Hey, are you taking stupid vitamins again?
This is a sick world we live in. All right, an exception can be made to the rule because after all, Slater is a lifeguard, but Zach, well, let's just say professionalism is not his job. Mr. Carosi, meanwhile, is having a midlife crisis, strapping aboard the home homicide while travel channeling his inner Evel Knievel.
Whoa, check it out.
He brings news of the upcoming charity ATV race, where many of the Malibu Sands members sponsor individuals to race.
How can you race TVs? They don't have wheels.
An ATV race, they come with wheels.
Mr. Carosi is a little flustered that he cannot drive an ATV correctly and therefore crashes into a fence that was inserted out of nowhere by, let me guess, Wile E. Coyote.
Dad!
Slater points out everything that is wrong about his ATV, but Mr. Carosi would rather slap him off as a petty peasant.
It's like you jammed the throttle, bent the clutch.
Wait, hey, that gives me an idea.
What? You fix it.
When Mr. Carosi and the gals depart, Slater reverts to kindergarten immaturity brat mode, making kissy faces about Zach and Stacy.
See you later.
Oh, Brett, you've been working overtime.
Slater, just chill out, all right?
Next, we get a most off-putting rank close-up of Zach's armpit hair that is disturbing enough of me, given the fact it was exposed to the sun, and I don't blame the sun for wanting to make a break for it.
Oh no, this is horrible.
Sorry, Zach. Stop trying to make hairy armpits a trend. It's not going to happen.
Oh, I know that.
Best advice? Better cover that up, Zach, before it turns into Cousin It and suffocates you in your sleep.
Hey, you know, that's a good idea.
Kelly becomes the first employee to be sponsored in the upcoming ATV race after saving a daughter some neglectful couple left out to die with their fishes.
Absolutely. Nelson, write Kelly a check for the charity.
So to avoid any further investigations into child neglect, child endangerment, they agreed to sponsor Kelly with some hush-hush money for not allowing their inattention to become today's top story. Screech appears to be following Kelly's every move, even if he has to interact with those of the Bad Parents of the Month Club.
I found your kid. You can thank me by sponsoring me in the ATV race. Go ahead and write out a big fat check. Oh wait,
he's not our kid, you goof.
That doesn't stop him from picking up one of the random children from A Christmas Story.
And even if he were, we wouldn't sponsor you.
He asks a nearby couple to sponsor him, but they recommend if he could go fuck off somewhere else, that would be great. To think he is a future principal at Bayside High 6 years after this series? No, he doesn't want his students at the top of the world, if anything. That kind of learning would hurt their creativity.
Look on me, dweeb. I'm not lost.
Kudos to Mr. Ralph Parker for kicking Screech in the leg to avoid another club abduction. He even goes again for seconds right in front of Lisa.
Hey Lisa, how would your family feel about sponsoring me in the ATV race?
Honey, my family wouldn't sponsor you for medical research.
The whole club basically voting Screech down for sponsorship, he stops to his old stalkerish charm in asking Lisa as a sponsor. She wouldn't sponsor anyone whom was going for the world record of attempted multiple kidnapping of children in a Saturday morning sitcom.
Well, thanks, Lisa.
You're welcome. See ya.
She does, however, sponsor Zach because eventually it was heading in that direction. The Child Avenger returns with his brother armed with a couple of super soakers, chase Screech down the beach as all the extras point and laugh.
Now on, leave my brother alone! alone, or you'll have to answer to me.
At the public shaming. Best child extras ever. Slater hears that Jesse has agreed to sign up for the ATV race.
That could be dangerous.
Jesse, of course, is all prepared to bake Slater, all in the name of feminism, a fresh batch of fuck off pie today, which includes one can of Nobody Cares, a dash of Kiss My Ass, and some fuck yous, sir.
Listen, Porky, women are just as qualified as men to race those ATM, those AT&T.
Then prepare as she intends to shove the race up his ass.
Take a male brain to drive one. You're so funny. Pardon me if I don't die laughing.
Stacy enters and notices them fighting when she is greeted by an unknown stranger.
Guess who, Stace?
Craig!
We find out it's Craig, her never been announced until now boyfriend, and he is here to turn Stacy into a Kelly Kapowski backstabbing whore.
Now, you didn't think I was gonna let an entire summer go by without seeing my girl.
Boy, Zach has more luck with women than NFL quarterback Aaron Rodgers, as both are victims.
I'm just pretty gutted.
Of the discount double choke.
But yeah, overall, just pretty gutted.
Mr. Carosi enters and introduces Craig to Zach Morris as a rich student at Yale.
And girls, you have my permission to drool.
Mr. Carosi holds him up as the golden son-in-law and his prime pick in the ATC race because apparently Mr. Carosi is not only an employee, but also a member getting some kickbacks on the side.
Zach's in real trouble. That guy's better looking, taller.
Craig asks for Mr. Carosi's blessing for Stacy for the esteemed honor of wearing his fraternity pledge pin.
Wear your pin? Why, that's wonderful.
A fraternity pledge pin, huh? An unfortunate side effect of wanting to go steady.
Imagine my little girl pinned.
Yet because there is no one Stacy would rather binge watch TV with in a desperate attempt to escape a world she finds more terrifying and perplexing than with you.
You know, she's all I've been thinking about. I only wish my fraternity brothers could be here to give her the rightful ceremony.
Screech tries to obscure Zach's view by, of course, spilling the beans.
Zach, ooh, you look tired. Here, have a seat. No, go home. I'll take your tables.
Zach, if you're hearing the voices in your head, slap the idiot, slap the idiot. Just go with it.
I feel fine.
No, Zach, I mean, please, please, give me your tables. I need the money. My cat needs braces.
No, Zach handles it the way he handles all crises. He walks out of his job.
Waiter, hi, I'm Craig Strand, Stacy's boyfriend from Boston.
Boyfriend. That's it. I'm out of here.
Back at the girls' living quarters, Jessie has an inkling to play baseball indoors as she is ready to bat that ass up as she hears that doorbell.
Gonna need the bat, honey. Just nag him to death like you do everyone else.
She hopes she can give them a taste of some of that feminism self-defense, but it's only Zach Morris who is sulking over her new girlfriend being a trash bag feeding whore to his two best friends.
Stacy? Stacy who?
Kelly gives him her condolences for being played like a fiddle again.
Zach, you know, I am so sorry. I don't know what to say. I...
Yeah, takes one to know one, Kelly.
Look, Craig showing up was a total surprise, and now that she likes you, she's in a bind.
Yeah, in a bind.
Mr. Carosi gathers everyone for a ceremony when Craig and Stacy walk on in.
What's going on, Craig? Why did we have to come here again?
You know, you've been so distracted ever since I arrived, I thought this ceremony might cheer you up.
If you think it's an employee ceremony, then Screech has more of his Betsy Crocker spaghetti sauce to sell you because it's actually a ceremony where Craig can give Stacy his fraternity pin.
Oh gosh, this is all so beautiful!
Marriage time already? I suppose the upcoming Super Mario Brothers Beach Pro AM is their honeymoon where they will consummate their love.
You to wear my fraternity pin. Now you're my girl forever.
Zach takes the news like most news of things that slips out of his fingers by walking out because a man of his stature and schemes cannot possibly compete with an attainable college fraternity pin. We return to the employee lounge and Zach is ready to pack up and go home, where Screech tells him the best medicine is to think of her in her mind like he does with Lisa.
Do what I do with Lisa. Date Stacy in your mind and you can save a lot of money.
No, Screech. That is not creepy at all. I mean, one minute you're out kidnapping random children to pass episodes of Stalking Lisa. You're growing more and more into a serial killer each day. No wonder the new class was always under new management.
Hey there, Lisa. I'll pick you up at 8 for the movies tonight.
Is he dating me in his mind again?
Lisa and Slater chime in for a pick-me-up about not wanting Zach to give up because his girlfriend has suddenly turned into a Kardashian.
The Zach Morris I know is not a quitter.
Yeah, she's right. Hey, don't let that jerk make you look like a total loser.
Gotta show Stacy what kind of guy she's missing.
Looks like Zach was going to let some filly whose boyfriend front him money into marrying him for publicity get him down so he enters the race.
Oh well, congratulations on getting pinned. I hope you and Craig are very happy together.
The day of the race is on and Stacy attempts to break the silence, but Zach is still contemplating if his consciousness is telling him if he has a chance with two girls in one season. After all, according to Screech, a guy can have his wet dreams, right? Stacy's beau, Craig, offers some pregame smack talk to Zach by showing off his crown jewel, Stacy, and to show him how fast he can get Stacy to make him a sandwich while he is contemplating serving up his own knuckle sandwich for Zach.
You might as well give up now.
Yeah, well, I'll take my chances. Oh, by the way, congratulations. You got a great girlfriend.
With our 5 contestants at the starting position, the race is about to begin. Yeah, they couldn't afford more than 5 ATVs in this episode.
Jesse Sparrow, A.C. Slater, Zach Morris, Craig Strand, and Kelly DePasta.
So it just restricts us to seeing 2/3 of the Bayside gang. Well, them and, of course, College Boy.
Get ready! Get set!
The race is off and Jesse loses control of her ATV and thus setting the women's movement back a long notch.
Oh no! Jesse's out of control!
We only hear the sharp battle cries of feminism as her Mario Kart dune buggy submerges underwater.
Help!
Yet the pom-pom princess Kelly presses on. We all know this was heading for a tidy contest between Craig and Zach Morris as everyone else was just told to make it look compelling. As Zach is about to cross the finish line, Craig pulls an old Mario trick, bumping into Zach's ATV, thus giving Craig the advantage to win the race. Everyone is chanting, "Fix!" while Stacy shouts, "Can it?"
Where is Craig Strand?
Hey, that's not fair!
Yes, I won a race!
So she follows Craig anyway because that's what you do when you're someone's go-with-the-flow girlfriend for the day.
What you did to Zach was unfair.
So what? It's not illegal. Come on, let's go, let's party!
Jesse survives her voyage to the bottom of the sea and decides to bring back some underwater seaweed jewelry with her.
I guess you were right.
Nah, don't feel so bad. Hey, you did better here than on your driving test.
However, she believes her feminism power should have prevailed like spinach is to Popeye.
I'm gonna kill you.
Stacy then meets up with Zach down by the back and he finally lays out his feelings for her.
Like, I should have said this way before, but I was embarrassed or afraid, I'm not sure, but Stacy, no matter how you feel about me, I love you. Okay, bye, have
a
good life.
Too, Zach.
Despite the fact that she sold you down the river for the next piece of prime real estate. The blue blood of Orange County, Craig.
Just, I hope you're very happy with Craig.
However, Stacy applies the quick kiss on the cheek to patch everything up and let's forget I only had eyes for the son of the Monopoly man. Funny, Zach actually walks off another easy girl whom actually choose him. So they are back together honoring the Saved by the Bell code that we never mention in the past again.